The second method for coal analysis is ultimate method, and under this the first is determination of percentage of carbon in hydrogen. Now here, if carbon is present in the fuel and it undergoes combustion, it will form carbon dioxide. Hydrogen, when it undergoes combustion, it will form water. Now in this process, we take two combustion tubes. These are two combustion tubes. In one we are going to fill KOH, in the other one we are going to fill calcium chloride. We know the weights of KOH and calcium chloride which have been filled in these combustion tube. Now carbon dioxide, which is produced because of combustion of carbon, is made to get absorbed on KOH. And water, which is formed by combustion of hydrogen, is made to get absorbed on calcium chloride. And by the absorption, the weights of KOH is going to increase and the weight of calcium chloride is also going to increase. And from the increase in weight of KOH and calcium chloride, we will calculate the percentage of carbon and percentage of hydrogen. Now, these are the combustion reaction, as I have already written. The percentage of carbon is given by increase in weight of KOH divided by total coal into 12 divided by 44 into 100. 12 is carbon and 44 is carbon dioxide. 100 because we are calculating percentage. Similarly, we calculate the percentage of hydrogen. Increase in weight of calcium chloride divided by total coal into 2. 2 is hydrogen divided by 18. 18 is molecular weight of water into 100 because we are calculating percentage. So by these formula we can calculate the percentage of carbon and percentage of hydrogen. The second component which we determine by ultimate method is the percentage of nitrogen. The percentage of nitrogen is determined by Zeldahl's method. Now in this method we take coal which is containing nitrogen. It is treated with concentrated sulfuric acid. In the presence of potassium sulfate and mercurous sulfate. Please make a correction here. I have written copper sulfate, but it is mercurous sulfate. Now, when these two are treated in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, then ammonium sulfate is formed. This ammonium sulfate is treated with excess of NaOH and the products are sodium sulfate plus we get ammonia which is evolved plus water. This ammonia which is evolved is absorbed on known weight of acid. And normally the acid which we use is sulfuric acid. Now, part of this acid is used up in absorption of ammonia and part of the acid is unused. The acid which is unused is determined by titrating it against NaOH. So, this is the whole process. Now, the percentage of nitrogen is given by volume of acid used into normality of acid into 1.4 divided by total coal which is taken. Now this has come after a derivations, but we are not going to do that derivation. Now in this we know the volume of acid 1.4 is constant. We know the total coal which is taken. What we have to determine is the volume of acid used. Now suppose, for example, the evolved ammonia was collected in 25 ml of N by 10 sulfuric acid. To neutralize excess acid, 15 ml of N by 10 NaOH was used. So if this is a condition, what will be the volume of acid used? Now in this case, the concentration of NaOH and acid will be same. Both are N by 10, N by 10. So in any condition, this concentration is not going to change. They will be same. Because NaOH is a strong base and sulfuric acid is a strong acid. Now, jitna bhi NaOH lag raha hai isko neutralize karne mein. So here we are having 15 ml of N by 10 NaOH which is required to neutralize excess of acid. Then, and total acid is 25 ml. So 15 ml of N by 10 NaOH will neutralize 15 ml of N by 10 H2SO4. So volume of acid used will be 25 ml minus 15 ml, that is 10 ml. So the volume of acid used will be 10 ml. This is how we are going to calculate it. Now this is determination of nitrogen by Zeldahl's method. Here I have shown how the final formula has come. So pura derivation bataya hai, but itna karne ki aapko zarurat nahi hai. Sirf last ye देखना है आपको जिसमें percentage of nitrogen determine किया है. This is the volume of acid used. This is normality of acid 1.4 divided by total core. So सिर्फ इतना पढ़ना है, बाकी ये derivation पूरा इसको जरूरत नहीं है. Then the third thing which we determine is the percentage of sulfur. The coal containing sulfur is treated with fuming nitric acid. Fuming means इसमें extra NO2 present है. जब हम कोल कंटेनिंग सल्फर को फ्यूमिंग नाइट्रिक एसिड से ट्रीट करेंगे, then there is formation of sulfuric acid. This sulfuric acid is then treated with barium chloride. When it is treated with barium chloride, we get barium sulfate. And from the amount of barium sulfate formed, we calculate the percentage of sulfur, which is given by weight of barium sulfate formed divided by total coal into 32. 32 because we are calculating the percentage of sulfur. 233 is the molecular weight of barium sulfate into 100 because we are calculating percentage. So this is the formula to calculate the percentage of sulfur. Then fourth, determination of ash. Ash ko hum bilkul waise hi determine karenge jaise approximate method mein kiya tha. And finally, we determine the percentage of oxygen. The percentage of oxygen is given by 100 minus the percentage of hydrogen plus nitrogen plus carbon plus sulfur plus ash. So this is the ultimate method for coal analysis.